Hello friends, welcome to TechStudySell. Now in this IoT project, we will control these four appliances from anywhere in the world with the Telegram app using the ESP32. Now let me quickly open the Telegram app. Then I will go to our bot. Then I will tap on start to see the menu. So with this menu, we can control this relay. Let me turn on the first relay. You can see the first relay is on. Now to turn it off, I have to tap relay 1 off. You can see the relay turns off. In a similar way, let me turn on the second relay, then third relay, then fourth relay. And if there is no Wi-Fi still, you can control the relays with manual switch. Let me turn on the first relay. And it may take some time while controlling manually. It may take 1 to 2 second time. And we can also see the real-time status of all relay. Just tap on relay state to see the status. And here you can see now all the relays are on. So this is a very useful project. You don't have to install any third-party IoT application. Everything is free. And after watching the complete video, anyone can make this project. So without any further delay, let's get started. To make this project, you just need an ESP32, 4-channel relay module, and 4 switches. Then connect all these components as per this circuit diagram. As you can see, the circuit is very simple. I have connected these switches across the GPIO pin and ground, and here I have given the 5-volt DC supply. As you can see, you can make the circuit without using any PCB, but still I will always recommend you to design PCB for any electronics project. And now you can order your custom design PCB from JLC PCB with these simple steps. From JLC PCB, you can order different type of PCBs at very affordable price. Here you can see they also provide a lot of services, and recently they have launched multicolor silkscreen PCB. After designing the PCB, you just have to upload a picture for your silkscreen in JPG or PNG format. Then place the order from the JLC PCB, and here you can see this is how it looks. And they also have free via InPad service. I will request you to see this clip, why it is very important for the complex PCBs.
When there are many solder pads on the chip, it becomes difficult to do the fan out. So we drill vias to transfer the traces to other layers. Note that we first extend a trace from the pad before drilling the via. While routing becomes much simpler, you still need to route at least one trace from pad to via, so there can still be issues with pads being too dense or too numerous to route effectively. If we directly place the via directly on the pad, there's no need for additional trace before via. But this can lead to solder wicking away through the hole during soldering, causing defects or cold solder joints. Via InPad technology addresses these issues. We still place the via on the pad, but then fill it with resin and plate it with copper. The surface shows almost no trace of this, and soldering is as reliable as with a regular pad.
So I always recommend you to use JLC PCB for any kind of PCBs for your next electronics project. Now before going to the coding part, we have to quickly configure the Telegram app. So let me open the Telegram app. Now first I will search for bot father. Then I will tap on this bot father, then tap on this start. Now from this menu, I will tap on new bot as I want to create a new bot. Now I have to give a name to this new bot. The name should be unique. I am giving ESP32 IoT 4 relay. You can give any other name. Now tap on this button. Then I have to give a username which should contain bot in that. So let me copy this name. And I will use same name, ESP32 IoT 4 relay. Then I will place underscore bot for this username. So this will be our username. See, our bot is created, and this is the token ID 8048. Now I will exit from the bot father. Then I will search for ID bot. Then I will tap on this ID bot. Again, tap on the start. So here I have to enter get ID. So I will tap on this get ID link, and this will be my ID 8250. So we need this Telegram ID or chat ID and a token ID from the bot father in the code. Now we can move to our coding part. So let me connect the ESP32 with my laptop. Now this is the sketch for this project. Let me open it with Arduino IDE. You can also download this sketch from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article, you can find the link in the description. Then download the code from this button. And I have also explained the code line by line in this article. So please do visit the article for any query. Now for this project, I have used this version of the ESP32 board, and you need to install these two libraries. And please make sure while installing the Universal Telegram Bot library, you should install all the dependencies. Then in the code, first I have to enter the Wi-Fi name, then the Wi-Fi password. Then here I have to enter the bot token. So let me open the Telegram desktop app. You can also copy it from the mobile phone. So let me open the bot father. So here you can see this is my bot token. So let me copy it, and this is the bot name. Then I will paste it here. Then I will again go to Telegram desktop, or you can also copy it from mobile. Then go to ID bot to copy the chat ID. Then I will paste it here. And these are the GPIOs for relays, and these are the GPIOs connected with the switches. You can see in the circuit, these are the GPIO connected with switch, and these are the GPIO connected with the relay control pin. And here I have used active low relay module. Then if I go to void setup, here you can see first I am defining the input and output pin. Then we are trying to connect with the Wi-Fi, and if the internet is connected, then the inbuilt LED will turn on. Then let me go to void loop. Then in the void loop, with these lines, we are checking if anyone tried to control the relay manually with switches. Then with this block, we are checking if there is any message incoming from the Telegram app. So here you can see the handle new message function. If I go to handle new message function, here you will find the comments relay one on, relay one off. So if you receive this kind of message from the Telegram app, we are controlling the respective relay according to the message. So the code is very simple. Still, if you get any issue, you can always visit the article. I have explained this code line by line in that same article. Now I will quickly upload this code. So let me select the COM port, then in the board I will search for do it ESP32 dev kit. So I have selected the board and COM port. Now I will hit the upload button. After programming, I have turned on the supply, and here you can see the blue LED is glowing, so it is connected with the Wi-Fi. Now let me open the Telegram app, then I will go to bot father. Then I will tap on this link to go to our bot which you have created. Now this is our bot. Now let me first tap on the start button to see the menu. Now this is our menu. Now first I will turn on the first relay, so relay one on, here you can see. Now to turn it off, I have to tap on relay one off, and here you can see the relay turns off. In a similar way, let me turn on the second relay, then I will turn on the third relay, then fourth relay. So here you can see all the three relays on. Now to see the status, I have to tap on relay state. So here you can see first relay is off and another three relays on. Now you can also control it manually. So let me turn on the first relay with manual switch. Now while controlling the relay manually, it may get some time to turn on the relay. Now the first relay is also on. So again, I will tap on relay state link to see the updated state, and here you can see all the four relays on now. So this is a very useful project, and sometimes the return message may not appear in your Telegram app, it may got delayed. That time you have to wait. This is the only issue caused by some server issue in the Telegram. Otherwise, this project is very useful. Most of the time you can easily control the relays with Telegram app and also see the current status of the relay. So if you find this video helpful, then please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.